I will become a pro artist in 1 year. But the question is, how? How exactly am I going to do that? The number one advice in the artistic world, if you ask, how can I get better, is just draw. Just practice. Practice a lot. And you know what? It's a terrible advice. Hello guys, my name is Doak, and as you should know based on this video, in the beginning of this year I set a goal for myself that I will become a pro artist in the year 2019. I've already started to work on my goal. The number one thing that I had in my head was that advice that I already mentioned. So I was drawing a lot, painting a lot, but guys, what? It didn't really work for me. I didn't see any big improvement, and I still had a feeling that I don't really know what am I doing. So I decided to change my strategy. I started to make a research, how to get better. I was watching videos, checking out books. They were super useful, but at the end, the only thing that I got was one big mess of information. I was confused and I didn't know where to start. And that was exactly that moment when I decided to create this strategy that will lead me through all this mess. A strategy, how to become an artist of your dreams. Where to start, what to do, and how to do it. In this video, I want to share this strategy with you, step by step, into depth look at all the things that will help you to get better. Shall we begin? I divided this strategy into 3 points: the goal, the study, and the practice. The practice point is divided into art and graffiti, but this is based on me. For you, it might be doodles and drawing or something else. We will get there. Before we get to the point number one, I would love to say that I created this strategy especially for myself, but I thought that it might be a good idea to share with you. Okay, if you want to become a pro artist, this is the point number one where you should start. First of all, you need to set a goal. You need to know where are you heading. My goal, for example, is to reach something what I call SMO level. SMO level. For those of you who don't know, SMO is my graffiti friend who I met last year. SMO is a guy who especially loves graffiti, but also apart graffiti, he's able to paint almost everything, from realistic portraits to crazy graffiti characters, landscapes, whatever comes to your mind. I want to reach his level because first of all, I want to be great in graffiti, and second of all, I want to be able to paint whatever comes to my mind, because right now I feel so limited. So basically my goal is to become great in traditional art disciplines as drawing, and I want to become great in graffiti. And you can let me know in the comments below, what's your goal? Where do you want to get in art? So right now when we have a goal, it is time to find out how are we going to reach this goal. The point number two, the study. If we want to talk about me, I'm an artist for about 12 years. And for this whole time, I never really studied what am I doing. Most of this time I was paying attention especially to graffiti, and I had in a mindset that I don't need to study art, I don't need to study anything about art. I didn't know what's correct, I just sort of felt what is correct for me. And that's wrong in some way. During the creating of my strategy, I found an interesting video on YouTube about muscle practice against fundamental practice. I will link this video in description below, but basically what it says is that muscle practice is the advice number one. Just practice, just draw. It's when you just draw. You draw a lot, but you don't really know how. And on the other hand, the fundamental practice is that you basically study. First of all, you study fundamentals of art, why things are like they are. For example, you study the light or the perspective. Things that I never really cared about. But today I know that they're super useful, also in graffiti. The conclusion of that muscle versus fundamentals video is that you should do both. You have to practice with your muscles, you have to practice with your hand, but it's very useful if you know why are you doing the things that you are doing. So I was like, yeah, I have my goal, So I will study, but what am I going to study? We have tons of resources, but the question is how to use them. If you want to study like me, you have to do three things. First of all, make a file in your computer where you will put all the useful information that you find. You can see this file as your notebook that you had in school for biology or whatever. That's gonna be the place where you will store all the important information. The point number two should be super easy. Get resources, videos, books, whatever. And the point number three in how to study is make notes. I'm pretty sure that just as me, also you have seen so many awesome tutorials on the internet. And many times you thought something like, oh yeah, that's wonderful information. But then you turned off that video and you just forgot. Write it down to that file. Take a screenshot. Copy the whole article. Save a link. Just store it somehow. You can do that in Microsoft Word, or there's another application that I find super useful. OneNote, also from Microsoft. You can have it on your phone, in your computer, everywhere. Every single time when you find some information, you write it down and you have it stored. That's the end of the point number two. Study. You have your goal and you know that you should study and you know how to study. Right now comes the point number three, the practice. In my experience, I know that practice is super important. We all know that. But what I found a little bit difficult is that I didn't really know what should I practice. You know, I practiced portraits because I knew that I want to paint portraits. I started to practice hands because I don't really know why. I also practiced these basic shapes like square, etc. because I heard somewhere that I should do it. But after a few pages of these basic things, I was like, okay, why should I continue with this? The point number three might be different for each of us. At the end, it depends on your goal. What do you need to practice? But there are some things that we all should know if we want to become pro artists. I divided my practice point into two categories: art and graffiti. After my research about art, I started to believe that it doesn't really matter what you want to do, but there are these fundamentals that every single pro artist should know. These fundamentals should be the base for you. And from them, you can move on to anything you desire. Graffiti, doodles, abstract art, whatever. I think that this is not a surprise, we all heard it at some point, that we should start with fundamentals, essentials. But my question was, what the hell are these fundamentals? Which of them I should know? So I will tell you right now. I'm just opening my art file where I have all the knowledge that I found. And if you want to develop a strong artistic base, you should study form and proportions, perspective. This one is optional, but anatomy, composition, value, and lighting. And that's it. You know, I always sort of knew that I should know them, but I always skipped practicing of fundamentals because I've seen other artists doing great things and I didn't want to paint just these squares and stuff. It really bothers me that I never really paid attention to them, because as you probably know, I started to paint these characters on walls. For example, the Predator painting, the Phoenix, Firefox. I was able to paint them. I believe that they look great, but I was basically copying some images from the internet and I didn't really know why, how. I have to admit that right now, when I know that I need to learn fundamentals first, I have this question in my head that, okay, so right now I will just practice fundamentals and I won't paint anything on wall, any realistic characters on walls. I won't learn fundamentals in 2 months, so how am I gonna do this? The only answer that I have right now is that I will paint these characters, but at the same time I will practice fundamentals and I will try to incorporate the knowledge that I get from learning of fundamentals into these paintings. And for this purpose, I bought this sketchbook. He's super small, which means that I can take him with me everywhere I go, and I can draw everywhere I go. And that brings me to the question, how am I going to practice these fundamentals? Well, I will practice them in the sketchbook. I won't do anything else over here, and I will go through all of them. And as it is a sketchbook, I will see my progress over here. I want to find some exercises on the internet that should help me to understand fundamentals better. And right now we are getting to the second point of my practice schedule, graffiti. I've been doing graffiti for 12 years. And it's funny that for about 11 years, I knew basically nothing about graffiti. I was doing everything just based on my feelings. Just based on my feeling about the shapes and colors and yeah. But then after getting off this book, Graffiti School, and meeting with Smo, I suddenly realized that there is much more behind it. I realized that there is some study behind graffiti. And my goal right now is to use this knowledge that I got to improve my graffiti. For practicing of graffiti, I also got a sketchbook. This one is a little bit bigger than the first one because I want to have more space for my letters. And I also developed a way how exactly I want to improve my graffiti. First of all, I want to analyze artworks that I create. Every single time when I create an artwork, I want to put it into computer and I want to point out the mistakes that I've done in the painting, also the things that I liked, and I want to write it down into my file. You know, every single time when I finish a graffiti painting, I see tons of mistakes. And I'm always like, I'm aware of them, but I can't really say that I remember them, and many times I do them again and again and again. That's something what I want to stop. The point number two is trying new stuff in PC. Most of the time when I paint, I prepare the shapes of the letters for the new painting, but I never really prepare colors or the final effects. Because the preparation of the shapes takes most of the time, and many times I just don't have the time for colors and these effects. I always say something like, I'll just figure it out on a wall. And that's a big mistake. I finish most of my pieces in about 3 hours, and then for the next 2 or 3 hours, I'm just standing over there and I'm thinking like, yeah, maybe I might do this, or maybe that. I just did it in a completely bad way. So the thing that I want to do is that I will take all the pieces that I created and I will try these effects on finished pieces. So the next time when I am on the wall, I will know what to do. So this is my strategy to become a pro artist. Yeah, right now where I share this strategy with you, I have no idea if it makes any sense or it just doesn't. It was making sense when I was writing these notes, but yeah, let me know in the comments below what you think about my strategy. I believe that it's gonna work, but the fact is that I will need to use these two guys a lot. Maybe I will need to buy more of that. I linked some useful videos that helped me in description below. And yeah, thanks for watching and see you next.